This is Radio 1. Record box.
One extra.
Hi, this is Zane Lowe from Radio 1.
What's up? I'm Mike Davis from Radio 1.
My name is Semtex from One Extra.
And I'm Benji from One Extra also.
We're here to celebrate birthdays.
That's right.
Everybody loves birthdays.
It's our third birthday at One Extra.
One Click's first birthday on Radio 1, and so we brought the two things together, and all four of us are going to sit here and play some records, right?
Beautiful.
Excellent. Starting with, what do? We flipped a coin. We won. You guys go first. And who's up to bat first?
Yeah, I'm going to go first. First joint. It's a sick joint. It's by Field Mob featuring Ludacris. Track's called Georgia. And it's like, it's giving you the flavor of what you can hear on my show every Saturday, 7 till 9 on One Extra, the Saturday Night Mixtape. It's brand new, sick hip-hop pressure.
You know, I stole this from you, don't you? I've been playing this lately.
I heard.
I rated your...
What time was that show again, Semtex?
7 till 9 every Saturday. Yeah.
Nice.
All right, this is bad.
Georgia.
We on the grinding.
Georgia.
All the time. It ain't nothing on my mind, but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you. We on the grinding.
Georgia.
All the time. It ain't nothing on my mind, but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you.
Country name, country slang, fiends at the liquor store. Black cruising, crap shooting, 50 on the tenor-fold. Overcast, the forecast shows clouds from plenty drove. And we ready for war in the state of
Georgia.
Yeah, dirty words, dirty birds, it's mean in this dirty south. You ever disrespect it, and we'll clean out your dirty mouth. Bulldogs clocking, these lookout boys is hawking. You gotta be brave in the state of I got five Georgia homes where I rest my Georgia bones. Come anywhere on my land and I'll aim at your Georgia dome. If you get in an altercation, just hop on your mobile phone and tell somebody you need help in the middle of
Georgia.
We some ATL thrashers, scope your pumpkin and smash her. We'll come through your hood worse than a disaster. Don't know who they gonna get or who them robbers gonna hit. That's why I keep my Georgia tech in the state of
Georgia.
All the time, it ain't nothing on my mind, but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you. We on the grind,
Georgia.
All the time, it ain't nothing on my mind, but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you.
I'm from the home and neck bone, black eyed peas, turn up in collard greens, sweet. The children of the corn, dirty than Bob Marley's DP. GA, the beach state, where we stay. My small city's called Albany.
Georgia.
Pecan country like catfish with grits, candy yams and chitlins, grams homemade baked biscuits, the land of facet for caprices and Impala super sports ingredients in this peach cobbler called
Georgia.
I love the women out in LA and the shopping stores in New York. She's an MIA, but ain't nothing like that GA red clay. Look on your mouth, we're right above Florida, next to Bama, under the Carolinas and Tennessee, you'll see. Well, Gladys Knight took a midnight train, the birthplace of Martin Luther King. Well, ass so plump and hip, we're lap truck sitting on 26s. Know where you're going or you'll be lost. Found in these plum trees in the south. These top of the tomahawk, your top down here in
Georgia.
Now you might come for vacation, leave on probation. Home in the strip club, known for the tip club. Where the tricks put tips in the tip club. Put a thick chick in the thong with a big butt. Wanna get love, won't be cheap, no money like peach tree. Make a chick take it off like freak me dying.
Georgia.
When you see them Confederate flags, you know what it is. Your folks pick cotton here, that's why we call it the field. I got a Chevrolet on 26s. I'm from GA. GA.
We on the grind,
Georgia.
All the time, it ain't nothing on my mind, but
Georgia.
We ain't playing with you. We on the grind,
Georgia.
All the time, it ain't nothing on my mind, but
So it's the big birthday celebration right now. One Extra's 3 years old. Got One Extra in the place. Got my man Benji B. I'm Sunsex. Got my man Mike Davis, Zane Lowe.
That's right. We're celebrating One Click's first birthday, a part of Radio 1's family. So we're here teaming up and we're doing this together. That's a nice way to start it off.
You guys have that album yet?
What, which one?
The Field Mob.
Field Mob album?
No, it's not out. It's not coming out.
What about the Kanye album? I got that.
I heard everybody except me has that record right now. I heard the receptionist upstairs got a copy.
You haven't got it?
I'm trying to make you a copy.
Yeah, Billy's got one.
I heard it's bad. Benji, tell me about it. Which track is your favorite?
Track 7's killer.
Track 7. Oh, yo, Benji, what's track 7 called?
You know what? I don't know. CDR pressure, isn't it?
Okay. Cool. So, Mike, you feeling that Georgia joint?
I like it, man. It's good. Ray Charles back in the house.
All right. Well, listen. Gonna keep it up with the ill birthday festivities. Gotta give a big shout to One Extra, everybody involved at the station, all the DJs, everyone who's put in the work over the last 3 years.
Yep.
While I've been on One Extra, I've been all over the world, been to different countries. But I think the biggest experience for me was when I was in Philadelphia recently, did my show backstage from Live 8.
Woo!
Philadelphia.
That's a big shot.
Very, very crazy experience.
Damn.
What's Philadelphia like? I've never been there.
You know what? I was there for like 10 hours.
Like for the DJ.
What does 1.5 million people look like?
What does it feel like to meet Stevie Wonder?
You know what? We were doing the interview, and then about 5 minutes before we're supposed to do the interview, the power cut and all the like interview tents. So I was like, oh man, I'm not going to do the interview. I was like, oh. Then the power came back up, and then I could see Stevie walking across from the other side of, you know, we was backstage, there's loads of tents and there's loads of other stations there. And obviously we were the heaviest station there. So he was walking across the road to come to us. And in my mind was like, you're gonna interview Stevie Wonder, you're gonna interview Stevie Wonder. And I nearly bottled it, seriously.
No, honestly,
I thought, I'm gonna mess up the interview with Stevie Wonder. Like, and I was nearly gonna tell Ronnie Harrell to do it. But then I was like, forget that, it's Stevie Wonder, pull yourself together.
You're gonna regret that forever.
Exactly. But I did the interview, and it's one of the best things I've ever done.
Mm. Wicked. That's a nice way to see in Live 8, man. To hang out with people like Stevie Wonder in Philly.
Definitely. It really made a big difference to hear the perspectives of people like Russell Simmons and Chris Tucker as well, because they gave a real positive spin on things as well. So
I think it's really good you guys were out there doing that too. I think it's really good that BBC sent One Extra out to represent the American coverage, you know, because Radio 1 obviously had everything covered out here at Hyde Park, and it was really nice that, you know, you guys got to go out and do that, you know, and I believe it went really well.
Definitely. It's hot.
So what's
up, question real quick, is anybody else going to play anything with guitar? Am I the guitar guy?
Nah, hey Mike, calm down.
Okay,
calm down.
I'm the guitar guy.
Hey, just calm down.
Is it a hip-hop convention that nobody told me about?
No. All right, we're going to keep it with the flavour, but I want to keep it with the UK pressure right now. The kid has got this joint, and it's not been turned up the street because hardly anyone's got it. Sorry, Zane. But it's by a kid called DWE. Joint's called D-Double Signal. This kid's flow is bananas. You got to check this out. It's Sensex, Benji B, Mike Davis, Zane Lowe, One Extra Radio 1. It's the birthday celebration.
I got this, I think.
D-Double, how did you think of... How did you come across him? It's like... everywhere I go, I can't help it. Just keep it up, man. It's very original. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double signal. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double signal. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. To come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double signal. You can't be critical about my lyrical. Got my old mouth to murk your new lyrical. But each and every one of my bars, they're my classicals. You know I'm never holding, I'm no international. Seemed to make peace like I'd be natural. That was an experimental. Now I'm standard on instrumental. I do it in the rave and everybody goes mental. The raving crew turn far from gentle. To MC, don't get me mental. Not get bust, get sent to the dental. About you wanna drop my dental. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double signal. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a
the lyrical. Ooh. That's the D-double-zero. I only deal with original rhythm. That's why man like me's getting written. Sure, MCs wanna be my position, well listen. You boy, you're on the long mission. Did a little kiddie dance since when I was kissing. From 13 I had a little kiddie vision. Spent time in the studio just like prison. Now I'm armed to the teeth for the little ammunition. And I represent D7, which is in Newham. And the MC wanna test in the doom. Whether it's inside or outside Newham. Bet you're wondering that I go straight through them. But my mark and all your crew knew them. Your lyrics, you're gonna have to redo them. Nobody cared, nobody knew them. Nobody cared, nobody knew them. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double-zero. That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle. That's the D-double-zero. No toleration for imitation of the nation. Equal domination. That's my solution to the generation. Use your mind on imagination. The new creation across the nation. Check out my demonstration. I interrupt to keep motivation. Satisfaction, that's my intention. Let me have to mention the Newham General's organization. We're signing trips to walk across the nation. Celebration for the invention.
Ooh, ooh, the TT. That's me, me. Ooh, ooh.
That's very original. Never heard that from another individual. Come across something like that was a miracle.
Ooh.
That's the D-double-C. That's very original. Never heard.
Hey, yo, it's Semsex, Benji B from One Extra, got Mike Davis and Zane Lowe from Radio 1 in the place. It's the big birthday celebration. That's one of my favorite joints from 2005 so far. D-double-E, D-double signal. Yo, it's totally sick. Produced by Miss Beats, first female producer to like make it big in the UK, so watch out for her as well.
How old is she?
17.
It's beautiful, that track. I love it.
I just picked up Target's latest DVD, Aim High 2, I think it is, and definitely D-double-E. Newham Generals is the best bit on that whole DVD.
Yeah.
Him sitting in Jammer's studio just doing the verses from this cut is heavy.
I was just saying before, just for people that weren't privy to the conversation while that track was going out, you know, he walked in a room when we were judging an MC competition last year at Forest Gate, and he walked in the room just unannounced with his little kid, and the whole place just erupted, man. And he must have took him about 20 minutes to get out of there because of all the autographs and photos people want to have taken and stuff. And he's, you know, he's just a hero, isn't he, out there, man?
Yeah, I mean, his flow's crazy. Like, the way that he rhymes, it's just, he's like the ODB of hip hop, well, of grime in the UK. And I don't know, man, I love tracks that really, you know, when you hear them, you're like, oh, what am I listening to? What's going on? What's happening? Because the way he rides over the beat lyrically is sick, and like just some of the things he's saying is madness. So D-double-E is definitely hot. 2005.
It's a beautiful way to start the show. It's this was 1 hour celebration of One Extra 3 years in, and One Click 1 year in, and like Sam said, myself, Benji, Mike and Sam are hanging out, and I think it's time for Radio 1 to represent now. Mike, can you step up?
Can you believe that One Extra is 3 years old?
Yeah.
Time has flown by.
Yeah.
Does it feel like you guys have been on air forever?
Yeah.
you know what? This studio, I actually did my first pilot in this studio.
I remember when you guys were doing those down here. Yeah.
And I actually thought I was never going to get on the station. Because I never used to talk on air. I was just the silent DJ.
Yeah.
It's one of them that mix cuts and
everything. With your hands, yeah.
And then Ray Paul was like, you know, I want you to talk. I was like, oh, I can't do this. You know, I really don't talk. And then I kept on messing up. And I really didn't think I was going to get on it. But obviously, you know.
I don't think people realize how difficult it is, or bizarre it is, to be a DJ and hear yourself in your cans and have to talk about stuff and knowing that all those people are listening to you. It does mess with your mind, doesn't it?
Definitely. But I think people right now, like, look at you, like, DJs.
All fancy.
To feel sorry for them.
Yeah, but all four of us have got one thing in common, and that's that we're into chatting about music, first and foremost, you know, and that makes it easier because we're all passionate about it, so. Yeah.
Definitely. So I got some hot pressure. Benji's got some hot pressure. Zane, I know you've got some heat there in the CD case right there.
Yeah.
But Mike?
I got some stuff, man. I do The Lockup, which is a punk rock show, every Tuesday night, 9 to 11 p.m., and then I'm back later on Tuesday night with a rock show from 1 to 3 a.m. And I also produce Fabian Grooverider. So I got a lot of, you guys got all the hip hop. I'm going to be doing some drum and bass tonight, some metal, but I'm going to start off with some ska. It's a band called Bedouin Soundclash, and there's a ska punk group from Santa Barbara, California called the Mad Caddies. And I grew up with those guys. They came over here and gave me this CD. And basically what it sounds like is like The Police meet Bob Marley in Canada in 2001. And that's kind of like the feel of the song. And it's beautiful. I know Zane's playing it. Joe Wally's been playing it. And it looks like it's been on the Radio 1 playlist. It's a nice summer song, so I want you guys to check it out. It's Bedouin Soundclash on Radio 1.
All right.
I
steps echo, echo louder than before. Another day is done. Say goodbye to the setting sun. See what I found. Turn back to the ground, just like before. And hey, 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 beautiful day.
Hey,
hey, beautiful day. When the night fills my soul, I'll be home. I'll be home. Into the undergrowth, twist and turn on a lonely road. In the twilight, it turns to night, and I'm alone. And when the light has left, I'm not sure of my every step. Follow the wind that pushes me west, back to my bed. And hey, hey, hey. Beautiful day. Hey, 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 hey,
hey,
hey, beautiful day.
Hey,
hey, hey, beautiful day. When the night fills my soul,
coming out in the middle of August, Bedouin Soundclass, When the Night Fills My Song. It's on Side One Dummy. I play that on The Lockup, which is a punk rock show, and me and Zane were just talking about it. We played 4 hours. We did a show on Radio 1, which is like the most punk rock people of all time, and we got...
supposedly.
We opened up a hornet's nest, basically. Does it happen in your worlds, too? Like, who's hip-hop and who's, you know, who's real and who's fake?
Well, if you're trying to do a definitive list, then you're definitely opening yourself up.
Yeah, yeah. Hip-hop's the most fickle, man.
It's a can of worms you've got to be real wary of.
I'd hate to be a rapper, I really would.
What kind of feedback did you get when...
It was positive, but it opened a can of worms.
It was easier to do it that way through a punk rock medium than it was to do it, say, through other genres per se, because with punk rock, the whole point is to kind of provoke reaction. So even if you get people going, man, that sucks, and how dare you put that person in the top 20 or put that song in the top 30, it's kind of punk rock to do it, and the best you can sort of justify it.
Four-hour show on it too, man. I wasn't looking forward to it, but it ended up being all right, didn't it?
Yeah, it was really good fun. I had a really good time, and we got to play like some pretty dodgy stuff. We got to play some seriously like profane language, which was pretty fun, you know. About 9:30 at night on Radio 1. Yeah, I think we got, what was it, 200 complaints?
Yeah.
So we're proud of that, of course. Yeah.
See, you know, like in hip hop, you get like the harsh lyrics, you get some things that kind of crude or vulgar or like used artistically. I mean, how does it work with punk rock? Because I'll be very real, I haven't heard any.
Punk rock, it just changes. It depends on what day of the week you're talking about. And I think usually it was people kind of associate two fingers up in the air and sniffing glue to be that's what they think of UK punk rock and like the Exploited and GBH and all those old school bands. But for me, when I grew up in Los Angeles, California, it was more about positivity and putting out records yourself and you know, putting on your own shows. And I think it's really changed, and I think it's definitely a healthy scene.
I mean, in a lot of senses, if you look at things like grime, even in the UK, strangely, there's a big punk ethic there because punk is about DIY.
Sitting in your house making
beats. Am I correct? I mean, I don't know much about punk, but what I get from it is that it's a DIY thing. It's a kind of democratic music. Yeah. Anyone can make it.
That's what I want people to take away from punk rock.
That's the same in every genre of music. It's the same. And you look at any sort of style of music that has changed the world and continues to be exciting. It all stems from a community. And all these things stem from communities. And then the industry catches up. And that happened with hip-hop. It happened with drum and bass. It happened with punk rock. It happened with pretty much everything. Eventually, people realize they can make money out of it. Then they get on board. And that's the one constant, you know? I think that's what is the energy that carries it through initially from the community.
I mean, I'm mad ignorant to, like, guitar bands, right? And right now in the UK, the whole indie thing is massive. Like, any group beginning with the is doing well. Yeah. The Kaisers, the editors, the whatever.
Yeah.
But I mean, how different is punk rock music to that? What's going on in the UK? Because I don't really understand it right now.
It's just, I think the indie scene, Zane probably knows more about it than I do right now. But the punk rock scene, it's kind of been going underground for so long. And whether people take notice of it or not, it'll always exist there. Mm. So it's kind of a cool position to be in. And when a band like Green Day, who are considered a punk rock band, sell 10 million records worldwide.
Yeah. I heard they smashed the show as well recently.
Yeah, they're amazing live. 60,000 people, they're selling out arenas too. And when bands like that do well, it gives opportunities for little punk bands to come through, and it gets the record label starting to sign these other punk bands. So it's, you know, you kind of sell out as in the eyes of a true punk rocker if you do well. But they don't want to see the fact that it actually helps everybody out. So
is that one of the defining things about punk, that it's underground, basically?
I think the purists and the people who are just boring and old and lame, that's the way they want it to stay.
Mm.
But at the end of the day, man, it's all about good music, isn't it?
Yeah, that's definitely.
If a song is good, the song is good. It doesn't matter what genre it is.
But it's true what Simtex is saying, because I think if you're slightly ignorant to guitar bands, you know, or you don't know much about guitar-led music, you know, you can easily get mixed up between metal and punk rock and indie
all
and
the subgenres.
And, I mean, what would be a defining punk rock record, for example?
Like, a defining punk rock record of all time or of right now? Or, I mean, if you listen to the new Green Day single, you're not going to say that's a punk rock record, because it's quite soft and radio-friendly.
Right.
And there's loads of hardcore bands out there, like bands like Throwdown. I mean, these are Terror, Madball, bands that you guys would never heard of, but they have been going for years. They have a big audience.
Exploited, maybe.
Well, what's the difference?
But yeah, a band like even The Clash, you know, The Clash, the White Riot and stuff like that, straight up punk rock and kind of aggressive, aggressive stuff. The Pistols, you know.
On a modern label, or maybe The Explosion? That track is kind of like a good example.
Yeah, it's more kind of poppy punk though too, isn't it? When people think of like punk rock.
Wow.
It gets deep, man. Let's just play some music.
And I never thought I'd be discussing like the depth of punkness.
It's
like,
good though. Never. It's good. I'm glad we're doing it.
Yeah, it's a first for Semtex.
I still don't understand, but you know.
Do you know the funny thing is though, man, is Dizzy Rascal to me is punk rock.
Right.
God's honest truth.
That's true, the thing, Benji, you're saying you don't understand. I do the punk rock show and I don't understand it either.
Mm.
I don't think anybody will ever understand it, you know.
Right.
But it's one extra sitting in here with me and Zane, Benji B, Semtex, Mike Davis. And we're celebrating 3 years of One Extra. We're doing One Click. It's been on the air for 1 year. We're having a little birthday party. And I'm going to get into my second choice. We're talking about big punk bands in the world. This is definitely a super group of sorts. It's the lead singer from Rancid. He's playing guitar. We got Travis Barker from Blink-182. He's playing drums. And Skinhead Rob, he's singing. And this is a track from the new album. It's called Doomsday.
Smoke. I lean back and I take my coke. I got approached by a shady bloke. He talked big, but he was broke. I was born in a shadowy world. Wasteland, mean and hard-boiled. With tragedies and turmoil. Disenfranchised and disembroiled. Lost flies in small fireplaces. I don't care what color your face is. One day you're gonna lose all traces. And warm cheer to all men and races. In the city again and out. Money always going to equal cloud. So I'm going out to scream and shout. In the city, but down and out. Preacher wants a judgment day. Junkie keeps the world at bay. Policeman wants us to obey. Doomsday. Preacher wants a judgment day. Junkie keeps the world at bay. Policeman wants us to obey. Doomsday.
Give me all that you got. Take off your shoes and fuck over the pot. I like your chain and I need the watch. And your girl looks good, she can travel the block. It's all here if you look in the store. I'm downtown San Pedro and Ford. Everything from the stem to the torch. And we hang them all high for a few dollars more. Said I won't, but I bet that I will. So when you close, I suggest that you chill. They all talk about keeping it real, but the second that it pop, I bet you almost will. Let it go, you ain't ready for drama. Kill your soul trying to rip my Nakama. And cause I want to, it's just that I got it. The whole conscience is a motherfucker, locking the daughter.
Preacher wants a judgment day. Junkie keeps the world at bay.
So it's the Transplants. That song's called Doomsday. If you like what you heard and you want to see them play live, they're headlining the Lockup Stage, which is my stage at Reading and Leeds this year. For more information, bbc.co.uk/radio1 and click on the Lockup. What do you guys think?
Yeah, man, I think that's heavy, man.
You digging it?
Yeah. I mean, people think, oh, look at Semtex. He's just a hip-hop DJ. He doesn't listen to anything. Like, but I like a lot of stuff. I like a lot of, like, you know, like some of the more metal stuff, like System of a Down. I think what they do, I think there's so many parallels between System of a Down and like your average hip hop group. It's untrue, where they make all the changes with the music, anger, the rawness on it. So
I agree with that. That sounded good though, man. Nice. That album's good as well, Haunted Cities.
Yeah, it's a great album. Mm-hmm. I just want to say too, man, that we're all here. I never get to talk to DJs really, but how cool is it being on the BBC that we can play whatever we want, just like we're doing on this hour show? We get to do that every week.
It's true. I get a lot of emails from across the world saying, you know, you don't get any shows in the US playing the kind of music that I play on my
show. Especially America.
America. It's the most formatted country in the world as far as... That's changing, though, because, I mean, satellite's going to break that wide open, which is why it's good that BBC is making inroads into satellite radio, because, you know, that's where the choice is coming from. Mm. You know, there's an enormous amount of sort of, I think, at the moment, subconscious rebellion that's sort of permeating through people who love music, who are rejecting what commercial radio in America is offering them, and they're looking for options, and satellite's going to give them a lot of options. So the more the BBC branches into that, and eventually we all get on there, then it's going to be great, you know. That's right. You're absolutely right. Sirius. We're going to start up and do our thing on Sirius, which is what I'm referring to. So,
are we going to get paid, though?
No, absolutely.
don't underestimate the impact.
That's the thing with DJs, man. Everyone thinks, oh, yeah, look, you get all the girls in the clubs, you get all this money, you don't have to do anything, you work like 2 hours a night and that's it. It's not true, though.
All right, for a start, we're DJs, so no girls know what we look like. Secondly, there is no money here because it's BBC and the people listening to it pay for it. If I wanted money, I'd have stayed in commercial radio, period.
I mean, that's the biggest myth. I mean, like, you know, I finished DJing. I'm funky, man. Like, I've been sweating for, like, 2 hours.
You know, I thought you were just saying, I'm just funky, just period. I just get down.
It's not good. Like, you know, you try to talk to a girl, you just look like the desperate DJ. At the end of the night, it's just like, no, it's asking you the time.
You know what it is?
Yeah, speak for yourself. Yeah,
being on the road, staying at hotels all the time, it sounds glamorous, but you're away from your home, you're away from your girl.
True. No, it's real, it's grimy.
You don't get any sleep.
That's true.
But I wouldn't change it for the world.
Definitely
true. That's true as well.
Probably the corniest thing you've ever said, Mike. Period.
I got a lot of love for you, Zane.
That's right. Life on the road is so tough sometimes, but I'm living the dream.
Yeah.
I'm living the dream.
It's true.
It is true. But, you know, you did make a really good point before. We're mucking around in here, obviously, because we've just been given, you know, a couple of mics and some time to play some records. But you're absolutely right about working for the BBC and the freedom that we get. And Benji made a good point before as well, and he said that we're all, I mean, the term in the office here is music specialists, and that we specialize in playing good music to people. Yeah. And we're not necessarily the most entertaining DJs with the greatest sense of humor or the most amount of whistles and horns, but at the end of the day, you know, we like music, and that should hopefully come across. And it's a pleasure to share some airtime with you cats as well, because I know we're all in the same game.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, I don't know about you, Sam, but on one extra, you know, all the texts I get obviously from the UK, but at least 50% of the emails I get are international.
Definitely.
You know, and I think that don't underestimate the effect that the BBC Listen Again service has had on that.
Yeah. You know, the maddest thing, right, I was in Victoria Station and I was screwing because I just missed the train. And some guy came up to me, right, this is mad, right, some guy came up to me, oh, Semtex, I've just been introduced to you online, I listen to your show every week in Tokyo.
Why are you taking the train, man? You're a DJ. Why are you taking the train?
The Humvee. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. The DJ biffs. The money's not there. So, nah, I had a big car accident. Like, yeah, I don't like driving. Yeah. So anyway, so I'm saying, some guy comes up to me in Victoria Station, like, yeah, I listen to you every week in Tokyo. I'm like, that's crazy. For me, I didn't really know what to say.
Blows your mind, huh?
Yeah.
It's One Click, it's Zane Lowe and Mike Davis for Radio 1, Semtex and Benji B here from One Extra. And Benji, you gonna play a track?
Yeah, definitely. The first track I want to get into is track featuring a UK vocalist, actually, someone called Steve Spacek. Recently been out to LA to put a record together. And this one's produced by one of my favourite producers of all time. Goes by the name of JD, a.k.a. J Dilla.
That's why all the problems, how I do it. So I can give you something, I'll give you and you. Let your dollar circulate. Let your dollar circulate. Let your dollar circulate. Oh, yeah, it's gonna circulate. Hey, it's for me and you. Gotta do it so I can circulate. Oh, I gotta give it up for everyone so we can have some fun. So in our hand around. All the hot and the cold, ain't no way to home. She ain't had to sleep on the road. She ain't had to sleep in their clothes. Oh, it's the same old story. Everybody's looking for glory. Yeah. Let your dollar circulate. Oh, it's gonna circulate. Let your dollar circulate. It's money for everyone, so we can have some fun. Supposed to spread it around. All I gotta do, I gotta do it for you. Let the dollar circulate. And you.
Let the dollar circulate.
Oh yeah. Ooh. Let the dollar ring around. Let the dollar ring around.
Let the dollar circulate.
Oh, it's got to circulate. Yeah. Let the dollar move around. Let the dollar move around. Yeah. So I'm doing it. And you, and me, and you, yeah.
Let the dollar circulate.
Oh, circulate.
Let the dollar circulate.
Circulate, circulate. Circulate. I'm working late.
It's 97 to 99 FM, son of the One Click Record Box meets One Extra. It's the birthday celebrations. You got my boy Semtex, Zane Lowe, Mike Davis and Benji B representing for both stations, both sister stations.
Can I just say that I have to say that song, and just for people out there that missed it, what was that song again? Who did it? And because that's just one of the heaviest pieces of music I've heard in a long time.
Okay, that's a tune called Dollar. Been hammering that one on my show Deviation, which you can hear between 12 and 2 on a Thursday night on One Extra. And I love that tune. It's two core artists for me. It's Steve Spacek, who's a vocalist from England that's a real unsung hero. Had a couple of albums already out as the band Spacek, but that one's produced by JD, who I really think is such an unsung hero himself. I mean, like, he has never got the shine he deserves.
He got a little bit, though, around the Beats, Rhymes and Life era, I mean, because he was really involved in Tribe Called Quest during that time.
Yeah, but he did his thing on Slum Village. Album as well.
But people don't know. What I'm saying is that, yeah, and I know that heads know, but he needs to get shine on the level of, like, Dr. Dre, Kanye West.
Because that's on some Curtis Mayfield, like, that's incredibly deep, that piece of music. That's
I was zoning out right there.
That's actually a sample from Billy Paul, track called Let the Dollar Circulate, and flip that real nice. That's off his latest Beat CD as well, obviously influenced by some of the kind of more soulful samples of that Kanye sound. But for people that don't know, JD, right, founding member Slum Village, that album, Fantastic Volume 1 and Fantastic Volume 2, had so much impact on the hip-hop game, influenced so many different producers, and
It was the swing, it was the kick and the snap and the swing, the
NPC. I mean, no disrespect, we all love Pete Rock, we all love Primo, you know, Diamond D, but JD, for me, I mean, he's the greatest.
he's definitely
the greatest, because he can flip all of those styles and he can flip his own. And I mean, apart from when you're talking about heavyweights like Dr. Dre and so on, I don't know what you think, Sam, but I really think he's been a very influential force.
I think he's cool, but I don't think he's what you're saying he is, in the sense that I think his sound's been a lot similar, which is why he's never really departed into the mainstream like your Dre, Kanye West, Neptunes, because I don't think he's done enough which is diverse or totally bugged out.
Because he hasn't got hits, basically.
No, not the hits, but I mean, Neptunes.
Come on, man, you can totally tell a Dre joint, you can totally tell a Neptunes joint, you can totally hear their sound.
But the thing is, as well,
beat, you
know? Like, Neptunes, they'll still come with a track tomorrow where you're just, oh my god.
But Neptunes are songwriters, they got hits.
No, I'm talking about the beats, though.
Yeah.
Like, forget the songs, forget who is ever on the track. I'm just saying, I think there's some producers who are just bugged out and are continuously bugged out every 3 months. I think the problem with JD is I think he's been in a bit, he's still in that Beats, Rhyme and Life era, that Tribe Called Quest era, and I think that's I don't think he's got a new audience. That's the only thing why he hasn't broken through.
Okay, I just think it's availability, because he puts beat tapes out every year that are just off the wall, you know, taking it to next levels. And I think that he's kind of not respected enough, because I think a lot of people have influenced him. I mean, even people like Rodney Jerkins, you know, when you get to the big level, all that finger snap stuff, all the non-quantized beats, all of that sloppy sound, you know, he really pioneered some of that. But
who's going to be the just quickly, who's going to be the first UK producer to break through, do you think? Who's at the top of their game right now in terms of producing UK hip-hop?
I mean, this whole UK hip-hop thing, the grime thing, it's like, to me, it's all the same thing. I don't try to be like, I specialise in UK hip hop, I specialise in grime.
It's rap music. Kano's album's a rap album.
That's
what it is.
But you know, there's a lot of good producers, but I think Diz has got, Dizzy Rascal, he's got the most bugged out ideas from what he's done on Boy in the Corner, what he's done on Showtime, and obviously he's biased because he's a good friend of mine and a DJ for him. But he'll still play me stuff from his laptop, and I'm like, I don't know what you've been smoking. Like, and that's what I'm saying, and that's a good producer. There's not many producers from the UK that give me that.
Yeah, definitely.
So we're talking music, obviously, if you're still listening.
It's late at night.
Hello.
Yeah, we're getting deep.
We went off on one there.
We're having fun right now. I'm Zane. Mike's next to me, and next to Mike is Sam, and next to Sam is Benji, and we're representing One Extra in Radio 1, celebrating 2 birthdays, One Extra, celebrating 3 years, and just going from strength to strength, and one click, celebrating 1 year, just baby steps, just going to start crawling real soon. So what are you going to play next, Benji?
Okay, it's another one away, a little Radio 1, One Extra exclusive for you, comes from Sara Creative Partners. We'll talk more about them on the other side of this, but this is Shorty's on the Block.
All my shorties out on the block. All my shorties hanging and hollering. Do it, do it, do it, yeah. All my shorties out on the block. six packs on the shake, make it six times. Now she down with me, for the world, it's quarter to three. No more talking, it's getting late. Make your mind up to the face. We won't go fine, hit and die with a Harlem River drive. Back at my bed, baby, let's get nice. White drink, champagne, chillin' on high, on high. You want a bubble bath? My time is short, girl, make it last. You want a dress? I'm in all. The shortest from the block, and she's down by law. All my shorties out of the block. All my shorties hanging in Hollywood. Do it, do it, do it, check. All my shorties out on the block. Making it hot, temperature rising. You just don't stop, shorty, get it, can I hit it, girl, I'm with it, can't my spirit, shorty, out on the block, block. Making it hot, temperature rising. You just don't stop, shorty, get it, can I hit it, girl, I'm with it, can't my spirit, we can play if you wanna play. On the dance floor, lead the way. Shake your ass, girl, shake it fast. You got class, girl, that's no gas. Girl, they find you, brown eyes and one with blue. You got to find things up in your crew. You came about me myself, so what you gonna do? All my shorties out on the block. All my shorties hanging in Hollywood. Do it, yeah. All my shorties out on the block. All my shorties making it hot.
Sana Sara, creative partners, track called Shorties on the Block. You got Zane Lowe, Mike Davis, Semtex and Benji B representing for Radio 1 and 1 Extra. Feeling that?
Very much.
Yeah?
It's wild hot, man.
Yeah, they've been passing me music for a good two and a half, maybe 3 years, and every time it's just getting better and better and sicker and sicker. And it's just culminated, actually, because they've just been signed to Kanye West's Good Music label for $3 million.
$3 million?
Yep.
Wow.
It's a very exciting time for them. I mean, I had them up on the show.
Is that good or bad, though? Does that mean Kanye is just going to be cherry-picking the best beats, or...?
No, that's good.
No, that's very good.
I mean, I know the money's good, but...
Now, Kanye's got taste, man. I mean, he signed Common, and he put Common in the top three in the US top 100 charts. Now, Common has been struggling with his last few records to find his erection ever since One Day It'll All Make Sense. You know, he went and found his guy for the right reasons, because he's from Chicago, and he loved him, and he grew up with him, and he looked up for him, and he put him on the spot, and he's given him some success. And I've never seen Common happier, and I'm sure you haven't either.
It's true. Is like the next Neptunes, the next Dre, the next big production team to break. Is it good that Kanye West has locked them down?
I don't think he has, I'm dictating
what comes out. And I'm taking all the best hits. Is that good? It's the smart.
Well, they came up on my show on One
Not
Extra.
Not Barry Gordy, man.
Yeah, exactly.
It's Kanye. He's cool. He's fine. Plus, I think he's cocky enough to be able to... I think he's more interested in his own-ish, probably, isn't it, at the end of the day.
Well, I'm sure that he went to see them live and he was like, okay, they've got the whole package. Because I've seen them live too, and they're just... It's out there. You know, there's people on stage wearing angel wings and crowns, and the backing singer's all hot, and the whole vibe is killer. They came up on the show... They're supposed to do a standard interview, ended up doing the whole show with me. We did 2 hours together about a year ago on One Extra.
Yeah.
And they left me so many nuggets, and literally not one is a filler. And they've got so many different directions that I think they really will be able to tailor make stuff for different people. I mean, they've already done production for Pharrell Monch. They did the Agent Orange cut.
Yeah.
They've got a little Underground 12 coming out with him and Dilla, actually, from LA, called Fish Filet. Semtex was just talking about off air.
Yeah.
They put out stuff through ABB and a couple of underground labels, but I'm sure that they've got the talent to really tailor make the more commercial ish for Good Music, Kanye's level, because they've got the songwriting going on as well, and that's crucial.
I mean, as DJs, we all chase down hot music, and like, some of us will go to some ridiculous extents to get it, and some of us will play it regardless of what quality is, like whether it's a good MP3, whether it's a white label which looks like it's been mastered in the bathroom or something. Mike, what's the craziest thing you've ever done to get hold of a track by an artist?
You want to tell that story?
That's X-rated.
Yeah, that, that, needs to be told.
But she's a great songwriter, and I'm marrying her next month, so in Vegas. So if anybody's out there, I think I've been pretty lucky. Just don't push my head, dog.
Because I'm close to the edge.
I don't know. I think that just the position that we're in, and the fact that we broadcast nationally and over the internet and stuff like that, and then we've been in this game for so long that I don't think we're in a better position to get music. People come to us first, don't they?
True.
Just for myself personally, and getting stuff from bands that will invite you down to the studio to check it out or whatever. But it's what blows my mind is working with Fabian Groovewriter, and I'm sure it's like this for you guys, but drum and bass is a different level altogether. They're getting stuff 8 months to a year up front, and I don't know, they're talking different language, aiming this, and they're getting...
I got a good story. I mean, it's a pretty well-known story if you listen to my show and stuff, but I mean, the Willie Mason story is pretty cool.
Oh, South by Southwest.
I mean, we were out South by Southwest, and it was our first year, and I mean, we were just following our nose. We didn't know what the whole process of going out and discovering new music was, except just going to gigs, and there's hundreds and hundreds of gigs across a week there, so, I mean, it's hard to cherry-pick, you know? And we were just talking to somebody, and we were just saying, well, who are you into? And we were trading names at the very start when we arrived. And he dropped Willie's name amongst many others. And so we were at a loose end one night, and it was even before the festival had really started. So me and my team went out to this venue, and it literally wasn't even on the strip. It was about a 15-minute cab ride to get there, and there was three guys at the bar who didn't even give a damn. It was their local bar, and there was me and my team, and poor old Willie gets up there and just starts singing these tunes with his heart and his soul. It doesn't matter how many people were there, and at the end of it, he was just like, Willie ever got his acoustic guitar, you know, and walked off, and we were like, man, that was incredible. We work at Radio 1. You know, we're here at South by Southwest, which is this music festival, you know, in Austin, Texas, where bands go to be heard and seen. We'd love you to come and play live in our radio show on a date. And he's like, I don't even know what BBC or Radio 1 is. I'm from Martha's Vineyard. I don't even have a clue. But I'll come along and I'll sing a song. And then a year later, you know, Willie's probably one of the most exciting young singer-songwriters in the world. So that was a really nice thing to be somewhere, just to be in the right place at the right time by pure chance. You know?
But Sam's talking about crazy. He's talking about, like, robbing, stealing, climbing the mountains. I guarantee you, he said that question to us because he's got a story.
Go ahead.
No. You know, I've done some craziness. Like, I've done some stupidness to get tracks, but I was to say, like, I mean, that was a deep story, Zay. I don't think I could beat that one.
Come on, man. You know you could. You're just being nice.
Yeah.
Plus, it's my turn. Plus, it's my turn to choose a track right now, so I'm stepping in. So I do this radio show Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday on Radio 1 from 7 till 9 p.m., and we play pretty much everything that all of us are playing in here tonight. I'll play tracks that Benji will be supporting, tracks that Sam will be supporting, tracks Mike will be supporting pretty much always after them, but, you know, I guess we're a nice conduit from those shows and bridging the gap between the real music heads, like you were saying before, Benji, and maybe some people who want to be educated who don't know where to find it. So a perfect opportunity to play a track by a band called Black Mountain. These guys are some serious hillbilly, drop-D, Black Sabbath, weed-smoking mofos, and this track is called Drugonaut, isn't it?
Letting up the sky. we drug or not. Rocky, rocky along.
Yeah, so that's the sounds of Black Mountain, and the track is called Dragonaut, and it's taken from a self-titled album. And you know, I don't really expect them to blow up at all, although they are doing some shows with Coldplay throughout America, so that might help. But yeah, they're real. You know, musicians love them, and there's just something about them which is dark and dusty and filthy and very kind of southern, as you can tell with a little, you know, Neil Young inspired solo at the end. But also, it's got very much a kind of acoustic drop D Sabbath type feel. It's very low tunings and real riff based, and the album's great, man. It's very good for the smoking incense too at some point throughout your life. Just pop the incense in a plant, light it, and just sit down on the couch and enjoy the sweet smell of legal incense. Okay, so this is Zane and Mike from Radio 1. Yeah. Dude, what do you think I do with my life on a Sunday? I just lie on my hip. That's all I do. And we're hanging out with Semtex and Benji B from One Extra, because they're three. One click is one. That's why we're all on one click right about now, and we ain't got that much time to go. So we're going to have to play another track pretty quick, I think. So the first time I ever hooked up with One Extra or met anyone from One Extra was at the very first Radio 1 Extra joint Christmas party that we had, and it was quite a nerve-wracking thing for me because I'd never been in a room with a lot of people, and I've been asked to DJ, and I was like, I don't know what I'm going to DJ. I'm definitely not going to play rock records. So I brought up just about 8 or 9 12 inches from my, you know, from the classic era.
I remember that.
88 to 94. And
we had fun.
Yeah, well, luckily for me, whoever was on in the main room at the very beginning started by playing, I don't know, Knees Up Mother Brown or something, which sent everybody from One Extra into the little back room where I was. And all of a sudden, I went from just playing like these little hip hop tracks to about 10 people to playing it in front of the nation's foremost hip hop drum and bass and urban, experts.
I wasn't there, but I got reports that you did very well, Zane.
I had to, man. Everyone was looking at me like, so you're the new signing, eh? And this next track I'm going to play is one that featured in that little hour-long set, which actually, I have to say, for Benji and Sam, goes down in history as one of my favorite nights playing records ever.
Yeah, I remember I followed you that night,
yeah.
And that was the way we first started talking, was because I played Crooklyn Dodgers, and you ran up to me and was like, Crooklyn Dodgers, that's one of my favorite tunes of all time. Blah,
that's
blah, blah,
right,
blah.
That's right, man, indeed. That's how we met, and it was really good fun, and I dropped this one. I remember this one getting a lot of rewind requests. This is Black Moon, who got the props. Hey.
But they got no show, so I'ma grab the mic, flip a strip, believe the stun. Buckshot's the one that gets the job done. Mic check, I get paid to wreck the set. Get ready to check, cause I'm a threat to your fret. No host bar, incomplete move fakers. Best to break the back of watch, you know I might take her. If she the crab, I'ma diss her then slide. If she try to rip, I got my Smith on my side. Word to God, here I come to make way. Rugged and rough, killing your set every day. Microphone check, 1, 2, here we go. And I'ma let you know who got the flow. And my verbs like an automatic weapon. Suckers keep stepping, cause I'ma let you know. So I paid them like a hippie from the 60s, but I'ma get paid from the 90s. Like to play your little rascal, my mic's time to get your flavor. With my lifesaver techniques, guaranteed to move weeks, and I'll go on for weeks. Maybe years, take my peers, give me ears to fill. Lick off a shot and act ill, parlayed and chill. See, I paid my dues, now you can't tell me nothing. This is dedicated to the ones who kept frontin', the ones who try to disimpose high, oh no. Just cause you had low, see now I got dough, and I'm paid out my rectum, meaning my backbone. Grab the mic, flip a mad script to your dome. Suckers, I kick them like Taekwondo. Yes, hello, from head to toe, to let you know. We'll be right back.
patience.
Sounds of Black Moon. The track is called Who Got the Props, naturally, and it's really old. And it's probably by far the oldest track we played tonight, but just hanging out with One Extra, I just want to drop that, just, you know, I'm going to show off a bit.
Yo. Yo, that track, I always zone out when I hear that, man. It's just like the way they flip the sample.
Yeah.
Ronnie Laws.
Yeah.
Shout out to Veggie.
Respect. Yeah. They're never going to let you in Melbourne with that kind of loose lips, do you know what I mean? And hip-hoppers in Melbourne don't like people talking about samples.
but I just think that was a really good period in hip-hop when that came out.
That's golden era.
It's around the time when Nas came out, Cypress Hill.
What was that, 94, 93?
94, 95.
Yeah, Souls of Mischief, Hieroglyphics, and all that crew. Yeah. So yeah, that's an old one, and we're gonna one more old one to play, which Sam's gonna introduce in a second. But it's been really good fun, I have to say. I wasn't sure how this was gonna go down because before we came in, I mean, we've all been real tired running around doing our own things. Mm. But it's been an absolute pleasure hanging out with you cats, just playing records and stuff.
Yeah,
and
same here.
Definitely.
We got told it was a clash though. Like, I came with my air horns and everything, ready to bonfire.
I went down to Music House, cut all these. Yeah, I didn't really even need them, man.
I had Westwood just waiting around the corner for the first half hour in case anyone would come in and drop some bombs on your ass.
So just remind me, when are all the shows? Because I want to make sure I check in with my punk rock, educate myself about that. Yeah. Zane, I know you're on every night on Radio 1, yeah. Pretty much, Monday to Thursday. Mike?
Lockup's on Tuesday night, 9 to 11 p.m., and then the rock show's on 1 to 3 a.m. on Tuesday nights.
Right, Sam?
Every Saturday, 7 till 10. Every Friday and Saturday, 7 till 10.
Easy.
Two shows now. Sickest hip hop, play everything across the board, from whether it's UK, US, the grime flavor, Dirty South, crunk, everything West Coast, you can check out all of them kind of flavors. Friday night mixtape, Saturday night mixtape, every Friday and Saturday, 7 till 10. This next joint.
Wait, Benji, when are you on again?
Oh yeah, if you want to check in with me, it's midnight till...
I can't hold back, man.
Just take over, it's cool. my show is midnight till 2 on a Thursday night on One Extra, and I play right across the board, all styles of underground music, some soul, some hip-hop, even some dance floor stuff as well. So, but it's been really fun doing this. We should do it again, actually. And if you want to get in touch with us, you go to bbc.co.uk/radio1, find the One Click section, and you can send us a message, let us know which tunes you are feeling, and... the messages will get forwarded to us all, I think.
Otherwise, you know, we'll see you in Ibiza as well, because Radio 1's going to be out there for the 10th anniversary of coverage out in Ibiza, which is happening August, I believe, August 12th, if my memory serves me correct. I'm going to be out there as well on an unrelated business matter, but I'll definitely be hanging out with Radio 1 at that point. You got your carnival coverage coming up, and, you know, this is what BBC Radio does best, man, as we go and find these events and we cover
One extra carnival coverage, like 18 hours of carnival coverage. That's going to be crazy. That's definitely, I don't think I'm going to be... sane that weekend. And watch out for the one. Sorry, Veggie. Watch out for the One Extra Freshers tour that's coming up September, October. Mm-hmm. And we're going to be coming live and direct from the Mix Show Power Summit as well towards the end of September. Mm. That's like the biggest hip hop event. Takes place in the Bahamas this year.
Is wow.
It? Yeah. Oh. They're sending me out to the Bahamas, man.
Someone's got to do it.
I've got to speak to HR about this.
you should go without saying, if you're listening to us on FM right now, make sure you invest in a digital radio so you can catch One Extra as well. But if you ain't got one, it's bbc.co.uk/One Extra, Radio 1 sister station.
Well worth it. All right, Sam, wrap it up.
Yeah. Well, how do you wrap it up?
What track are we going to play?
This next joint, I mean... I don't really want to talk because I won't stop, but Public Enemy changed my life. That's all I'm going to say.
This is the version. This is the version with Anthrax, all right?
Sorry. No,
all I can say is Bomb Squad. Well, actually, there's nothing that can be said about Bomb Squad production, but Public Enemy are, without question, the most important and most influential band in my life, full stop.
Yeah, period. You know, I have to say, I want to weigh in for a second. You know, I actually had a chance with my group back in New Zealand to support PE once. It was, without that, one of the finest moments of my entire life, especially when my shoe came off during the first track. So we went to the photographer's pit. That's another story. To wrap this up, I think, Sam, you said it best when you said, when we all come together, we don't know what's going to happen, but bring the noise.
Too black, too strong.
Yo, Chuck, these dirty dribbles are still front on us. Don't know we can do this, cause we always do this. Ha ha, yeah, boy.
Bass, how low can you go? Death row, what a brother, no. Once again, back is the incredible rhyme animal, the uncannibal. Public Enemy number one. 5-4 said freeze, and I got numb. Can I tell them that I really never had a gun? But it's the wax that the Terminator X-Bun. Now they got me in a cell, cause my records they sell. Cause a brother like me said, well, Farrakhan's a prop. think you wanna listen to what they can say to you. What you wanna do is follow for now. Tell what the people say, make a miracle, keep up the lyrical. Black is back, all in, we're gonna win, check it out.
Yeah, yo, come on.
Here we go again. The brother is madder than mad at the fact it's corrupt like a senator. Soul on the road, but you treat it like soap on the rope, cause the beats and the lines are so dope. Listen for lessons I'm saying inside music that the critics are blasting me for. They'll never care for the brothers and sisters. Why, cause the country has us up for the war. We got to get them straight. Come on now, they're going to have to wait till we get it right. Radio stations are questioning black as they call us a black, but we'll see if they'll play this.
Radio 1, 1, 1, 1, 1.